Now, I do want to talk about the course a little bit. I feel like every year we hear more and more backlash against the USDGC for course design.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, last year there was an anomaly in what was holes 3 and 4. But I'm not going to worry about those. Because those are gone.
They scratched
them. Went back to 1 and 2.
Yeah.
What's your opinion on the amount of ropes and ways that they make the course hard?
Right.
Do they overdo it?
I will say this. I'll applaud the USDGC for initially designing a course that, for the most part, has held up to today's competition. From literally, I'm reading this article today, and Barry Schultz is talking about how on 18 he threw his DX beast. Like, the game has changed a lot. A lot of it is because of the equipment. And for the most part, it's kept its structure. And I think a lot of that has to do with, because the event is so prestigious, guys just play nervous out there. Like the old hole one, I loved the old hole one. I'm talking about the straight little putter shot, because guys would miss that hole all the time because it's, you got jitters.
Yeah.
And like, that's, you know, you're a good event when you can be difficult just because of how much people want to win.
Just because it's USDGC.
Just because it's the name, right?
Even when we were playing Dean's Cup, which had nothing to do with the USDGC.
It's nerve-wracking.
But you were on the course and you heard your name called by the same guy. Yeah, your nerves skyrocketed.
Yeah, it's
shocking. Even just stepping up to 17th tee in a practice round, you look at it and you're like,
whew. Yeah.
Because there's just history behind it. That's the biggest thing, is the history behind that course. But
as far as like adjusting it though, like the ropes, I've never had a problem. I love like having all the ropes OB, and they've made some changes. Like you can pretty much, I don't think they've tightened the ropes to a point where it's like, okay, come on. Like they're still fair enough, the ropes. And I like the way they're placed. The OB makes sense there typically. The biggest complaint people get is the mozzarella sticks, the wooden poles that are next to certain baskets. I think they're on 2,
16,
and there's one in the middle.
8, I believe.
Is it 8?
Yes.
So basically what they're doing with those holes is they're trying to add some kind of defense to the hole by forcing you to throw your upshot to a certain place. It seems like that's the goal of the mozzarella stick, is like, we want you to throw your drive or your upshot on a harder line.
Yeah.
Because you throw it the easier line, you're now dealing with these random wooden poles. A good example of that would be on hole 2. If you take it over the parking lot and land on the left side of the basket, right? You're not dealing with them.
Yeah.
If you play towards the fence, a little bit safer.
Which is the more common play.
The more common play, you're going to have to deal with mozzarella sticks. So like, that's an example of that. And here is, if that's the goal, if that's what they're trying to accomplish with those, they look so bad and they're so annoying. There's a more elegant way to do that. And I think it is hazard bunkers or areas, right? So if you land in it, you're getting a penalty stroke, but you're not putting through some wooden pole. You're just putting from where you landed in the hazard. And it still makes it so that you have to do the same thing. You have to throw your upshot a different line because you're avoiding something. So I think there's just a more elegant way to do that. And like, some sand bunkers would look like really, really nice in that course. It would fit the aesthetic. There's sand on hole 6.
Mm-hmm.
Looks great. Like they could do that. I guess that might be confusing that sand's not OB, but the other ones are. But that's the only problem I've ever had, I think, with what they've done to that course to make it more difficult. And I think it's a pretty much a consensus. I mean, even Evil McMahon himself, you know, a top pro, despises them. I don't think I've ever heard anybody say they're a good addition.
Yeah, I mean, Dustin Keegan, I think, Innova posted a picture, or it might have been USDGC, posted a picture of like hole 16 and said, how are you approaching it this year? And he said, with a chainsaw to cut those things down and then go back to play a real hole.
Yeah, and Eagle reposted it.
Yeah, Eagle reposted it and said, like, that's amazing. But I honestly think that I might, and it sounds like you're in the same boat as me, we might be in the minority in this part of it, where the ropes, as a spectator, and even when I've played the course, I've never been as a competitor, but playing the course just like warming up, they don't bother me.
No.
Because to me, I think the hard part is like the visual of it. People don't like, looking like hole 3, for instance. There's no rhyme or reason to shaping the fairway the way they did.
Right.
It's the ropes just on the left, to where it might be hard visually watching to tell if someone's in bounds or out of bounds. Okay. But I think that what you said is a good thing, is like, they've succeeded in keeping the history of the course together And the ropes allow them to change the course enough to make it tighter in some spots.
Yeah.
You know, lengthen the whole landing zone, like where you want to be landing and stuff like that, to where it can adapt. And it can challenge, consistently challenge the top of the game over and over and over.
And we've played it. We've played these ropes. I've seen them in person. I've thrown them. And they are completely fair.
Yeah. And you can, once you've played it and one practice round, you know
where it is.
Yeah. When you release your shot, it's never... It might be confusing if it rolled or not, if it's inbounds. Yeah. But when you release a shot, you know where you're getting to. And it's very challenging. And they've done a great job of that. And another thing that plays into this is the fact that they use two different types of OB. But they do have hazard and they do have OB.
Yeah.
That is something that we've pushed for on this podcast before. And I think this tournament reiterates it. I think it's great. And I think that that should be a common thing in disc golf, that there's hazard areas and that there's OB areas and that they're two different things.
Mm-hmm.
Because, for instance, on hole three, if you're very short, you're OB. So you're basically re-teeing, I believe, is your only option at that point with a stroke. Whereas if you're up by the basket left, you have a putt and a stroke penalty.
Yeah.
Now, I don't advise, you know, a regular like amateur tournament just throwing hazard into the middle of a field. But when you have something like Sand Trap, if you're playing a golf course, you know, Las Vegas Challenge has done that. Or you have something that's kind of a natural hazard, you know, something, I don't know what it would be in the woods, but, you know, something that you can rope off and be like, hey, if you land here, you're still playing from there because you didn't throw a great shot, but you're also penalized one stroke.
Mm-hmm.
I think that type of stuff can add to where we can make courses slightly more difficult, slightly more challenging, make players have to think on their upshot, because that's something in disc golf. If you throw a good drive, a lot of times your upshot, you're rewarded with just, all right, just get up and down. It's pretty easy. The drives are a lot of times the difficult part, whereas upshots don't have something naturally challenging a lot of times.
Yeah, I like the idea of like defense around the hole, because in ball golf, they can obviously move the pin around to make it so like your position A isn't always just like, and this is, there's starting to be some courses I've seen where like your position A isn't just like, okay, I'm just going to throw it and get as close to the pin. It's like, I'm going to throw it and aim for the left side of the green, because like I don't want to mess around with the pin that's hugging this. Like,
yeah,
I think that's too a thing. Like pin placement, like near OB, is like really important to making those upshots difficult. Because like 17 is a good example of this. Like, you obviously your strategy on 17 is not to attack the pin.
Yeah,
especially when it's in that left pin, you're aiming to dump about 25, 30 feet right of it.
Yeah, and then
I want to I want to see more. I want to see, like, and I'm not saying you shouldn't have the pin accessible, because there's courses like that where you throw the perfect shot and then you're still 30 feet away. No, you should, the pin should be accessible, but your play should be to land a bit further out, because that is what will make putting more important in the game and maybe drop scores a little bit.
Yeah. So I think as far as the ropes go and what they're doing with hazard and OB, I'm a fan of. You know, yes, there's a lot of it out there, a whole lot, and I could see where your first time watching it's confusing, but as far as the mozzarella sticks, these wooden poles, I don't like them.
They are an eyesore.
I don't like them. I think it just kind of makes the USDGC look gimmicky to a certain degree.
Yeah, they're pretty dumb.
I just don't like anything that close to the basket.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing. They're so close to the
basket.
They're
like within 10 feet.
Yeah.
And so you have like on the FPO coverage on hole two.
There should be nothing within, unless you're like thick in the woods, like you really shouldn't be anything inside of 30 feet.
Yeah.
Like if you're in the circle, you should be rewarded with a putt.
And that's the thing too, is it's designed for making the upshot harder, right?
Yeah.
But it also has repercussions outside of that, to where Haley King on hole two today, this morning, she had like a, I want to say like a 50 some footer that she threw, it looked perfect for her birdie.
Yeah.
And then it hit a mozzarella, it just clipped a mozzarella stick and kicked to the right.
Yeah.
And then, you know, so that's not what that's there for, but because it's a physical thing standing up and down, it's punishing people farther back the fairway as well.
Right.
Whereas that's not really, that wasn't necessarily the goal of putting them in. And the second thing it did is it takes, still on hole two, I believe it was, Paige had like a 25 footer and had to basically do a full split to be able to see the basket. And I think she still missed left because she couldn't quite see the full basket.
Yeah.
That just make, I don't like that. I think that just makes the sport look silly to a certain degree. Whereas it could have the same effect if Paige was putting from a hazard area, or if it's a casual, like if you throw right, it's a mandatory casual relief area where if you might be 15 feet and now you have to take relief to 27 feet.
Yeah.
Because you're in this mandatory relief area. Or something. Yeah. I don't know. There's other ways around it that visually don't, that provide the same effect score-wise.
Sure.
But don't visually make our sport look gimmicky.
Yeah.
That's the biggest thing to me.
Yeah, we just got to avoid that disc golf.